What is up, guys, and welcome, well, technically back to Oxygen Included. I know I played a little bit of this back in the earlier days on the channel, but it's just one of my favorite games, and I don't know if I'm still on the series or not, it's debatable, but I like playing this game, so we're playing it. I know it'd be more entertaining to see me do survival, so go ahead and do survival. Okay. I always choose the easiest difficulties on playing this on my own, so this may either go really, really bad or really, really good. If the world ends, I'll just start over. Alright, so. Start looking at our characters here. So because I'm doing this in an actual difficult setting, I want to make sure I have the best things possible. This guy has got a 7 plus 7 in machinery. Early on, that's not going to do me much good, but do I think I could get a... Let's just keep it athletics. That's useful. Agriculture and strength, that's a pretty good balance. Let's look at their early. Okay, so this person has really good morning traits. So if I switch his schedule around to where he gets up a little bit earlier to work, then that could be useful. Now this guy takes forever to use the bathroom, which is not bad. That's not a bad thing. He's an ugly crier. Sparkle streaker. Something nice to a... What's that say? A son. He'll think about it nonstop for no less than 3 weeks. Okay, so this guy's got, well, this girl has got an iron gut, so she doesn't get food poisoning. That's useful. But she's a loud snorer, so we'd have to give her a bed on our own away from everybody else. Which would be an issue for spacing, but it's not a really bad issue. Okay, so this person's reaction to stress is binge eating, which could be an issue if we're having a food shortage, but it's not a terrible thing. Also, a good streaker. This one's overjoyed reaction is super productive. That's good. But they're a binge eater as well, which is really bad. Okay, so this guy is actually really, really nice. So this guy is a night owl, which is a newer trait that I'm aware of. Basically, it makes it so that way if I have him work during the nighttime, he actually is more productive. His attributes work really well at night. So that means I'll have him sleep during the day rather than. Okay, I'm going to keep the name Citadel just because that reminds me of Rick and Morty, so let's do this, other than the basic one. We're going to go ahead and pause and kind of look around real quick. What is this? Ice liquefied, really cold. Temperature down here is not bad. Not bad. So it looks like this center zone is actually not really hot. 22 degrees Celsius. I wish it was in Fahrenheit. I know Celsius is probably a better way to measure stuff like that, but I thought this was a hot planet. It said volcano. Got polluted water up there. Bunch of metal resources there. Ice is probably going to make my guys really cold, so I've got to be careful with that. Okay, well, let's just go ahead and get to work. Let's just have them start digging and go from there. There's a bunch of loose water over here. What's the temperature of this water? Is it getting hotter as it goes over? So I'm thinking there might be a geyser. I want to go inspect it out. So let's go ahead and dig out this right here. I'll go from there. A lot of oxygen. Okay, they dug it out. Good source of water over there. What I'm gonna have them do though is I'm gonna have them first. We're gonna build a ladder straight down right here, and then we're gonna have them build a second platform. I'm gonna do it by sets of four, like that. dig all that out as well. Go ahead and place the platform up here. I'm not going to dig out that oxygen chunk yet. Actually, let's go over here. We're going to dig out some stuff over here. Actually, cancel all what I asked them. I want them to focus on digging over here first. So, we're going to build... Nope, new plan. Okay, we're going to have them go straight down right here. Shit. I'm going to go down straight right here. Okay. And they are going to... Now let's just keep going down. All the way down into the water here. Yep. And then we're going to go over here and start building. What the... Is that more water? Shit, there's so much water. Okay. New plan. Cancel all that. Build down to here, because I want them to get all the water in one area to make a good, large-sized water source. I'm going to dig straight down. All the way down here. Okay. Go ahead and go with this. I think you kind of dig. Let's go up here and have them start digging over here. I want platforms. Sleep for the first 3 hours of the day. endeavor. Okay, all that water's draining down into there. At least once we do have everything figured out, we have a lot of fucking water. Thank you.
get all that dug up. Make a massive water tank. Construction's coming along pretty good. I kind of paused it for a minute there so we can get through some stuff. But I'm going to go ahead and come back once this is done. Do you have another night owl? What do I need sand? I think I have enough sand. This one's got two native traits, so let's avoid that. This guy's a good deer. It's not an issue for me. Alright, so they finished making the tank. I'm putting a way for them to access the water over here. Like, I'm gonna put the pitcher pump for them to pump out the water whenever they need it over here. So that way they don't have to get it. It's just like, produce. There is so little oxygen and it has no issues burning out oxygen.
think they're spitting that oxygen. It's good. I can tell the oxygen is starting to fill the area, which is exactly what we want. Let's go ahead and set up another one. Check out our skills tree here. Each one of them has a single skill point, so let's put it towards something. This guy likes digging, give it to him. This guy likes building, give it to him. Another digger, let's go. Research, definitely need a couple of advanced researchers, so just give all three of these guys researchers. Eventually that oxygen just starts hanging up on top of it. Okay, yeah, it is working its way up there. He's gotta finish filling this area first. So oxygen is starting to get around. I should probably put another oxygen diffuser up here. We've got people standing around, let's pause it and don't waste time. Let's get some storage bins made. Here 9, here 1,
looks like I was right. It looks like it is trying to balance out, so we need to decontrol this guy. I was looking at the water level and I noticed it's actually going up, which tells me that it's actually transferring from this side to this side all the time. So we're going to pitcher pump. So, I've been having them gather stuff and get things picked up and stuff, but we have something else to work on now. We're working on setting up research stations down here, but we're running out of metal ore. I can't even make food because I don't have any metal ore, so I'm going somewhere else. Okay, that done. We're having a food shortage now, so I need to get food stations made. Prioritize this entire build down here. Sure. And then once they're going to get a little bit there, they'll focus on getting that down. Carefully getting up to that polluted water. A single tile or two of the water's not that bad. I can clean that up. So when we get to, like, the whole lake of it. I don't want it pouring straight down into my water source. But I got enough fucking water in there. I'm also going to need to prioritize this over here and get this cleaned up. I also want to build that wall up. Pitcher pump put in. Put it back right. We got oxygen, which is awesome, but algae could be really useful because that's a finite resource. I don't think I should take any opportunity to put algae. Some more toilets built as well. One more toilet. And then a wash basin as well. We got the pitcher pump and everything. Let's go ahead and just prioritize it. All the way to prioritize that and that. We made a mess. No, stop that. Decide what I want to change the priorities to. So number one, maintenance needs to be priority. They got food, they got oxygen, and they've got outhouses, so I want them to heavily prioritize research. Oxygen scrubbers, try to get carbon dioxide out. Thank you.
stuff up. Alright. If we finish building all that, we can find out from this one. Okay. 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 That, so let's get research started. Let's go up here and algae terrarium. Yes, that. We'll have other oxygen resources. That is the carbon dioxide all flows down with the water tank. I can filter it out. Okay, what we got? Brine, don't need brine. Oxalite. I don't know if that's even useful because I don't think you can place it out. It has strength. It has a very strong strength. Flowers. Oh, looks like you win. Crank out the research. I'm thinking we just start producing everything, starting at the top. I say we turn the priority of everything else back down to one entirely. Then we only worry about research and producing power for said research. And oxygen needs to be pretty important. So knowledgeable in food, and yet we're still making mush bars.
tanks. I think I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up here in a second, but we're gonna start working on getting a lot of this research done over time. But I think next time around, I'm gonna do the airflow and water flow tiles, so that way I can do some nice decoration and stuff like that to make things a little bit easier. I do want to figure out how to heat up the area, because it is a very cold environment where I'm at, despite the map being called Volcano, which I think is kind of odd. But we're doing pretty good, all things considered. So we got a lot of research going on, we got power going on. We need to upgrade our power situation as well as our food situation. Oxygen, it keeps going on and off about whether or not we're producing enough. I think we're producing right at what we need to without producing too much. If we get any more duplicates, that might change. We need to probably prioritize food. I probably should set up a few more food mushers and start producing a lot more food. As far as later game food, I think it would be a good idea for us to start some farms and get into some better food resources, because these are not great, because they're eating dirt and water. It's literally what they're eating. It's keeping them fed, but not well. The morale is really low, so we'll probably start working on doing some decent decoration in places, set up individual bedrooms at some point. For now, though, guys, I think I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to give me a big old thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, click on the bell down below to let you know when I upload videos to YouTube, and if you guys have anything to say, let me know down in the comments. For now, though, guys, that's going to have to do it for me, so I'll see all your beautiful faces in the next video. Bye, guys!